Let's talk about Gary Wiebenga. I know you English-speaking people pronounce it as Wiebenga, but it's a Dutch name by origin and I like to pronounce it the Dutch way. So, Gary Wiebenga and his acute angles. Flat earthers have come up with the most exotic and the most incorrect explanations on a flat earth of this phenomenon. Ships disappearing behind the horizon bottom first. Or buildings doing the same thing. But Gary has been the most consistent one. Since 5 years now, he is claiming that objects disappear bottom up because of the viewing angle that gets less the farther away the object is from the observer. In a reaction to my latest video, he still does it, be it that in his wording he is a bit vague. So I decided to visit his channel and look for a video where he explains what he means. And I found it. It's this one. I edited some of it out, but you get the gist of it.
From the first one to the first story, our 45 degree angle was already right here. On this one, it's clear on this end. So which do you think is going to get smaller faster to the point where you can't resolve it as separate from the ground? Obviously, this one to the bottom story, because it's already down to a 9 degree by the end of this sixth section, where the other one to the top didn't reach the 45 degrees till here. Now you tell me, in your field of view, what's going to take up more space, the 9 degree angle or the 45 degree angle?
What it comes down to is that, after having drawn a multitude of lines of sight at various distances and to various heights, he concludes that the angle to the first floor always is smaller than the angle to a higher floor. He ends with the somewhat dramatic statement,
"The bottom has no choice. The angles dictate what you see. The smaller angles will become unresolvable and it will be bottom first. There's no way of doing this any other way. This is very simple, basic geometry. Sucks to be a globie, doesn't it?"
He could have sufficed with just those two lines of sight. But hey, he has to make something out of nothing, doesn't he? And he definitely has nothing other than a terrible mistake. He says that the angle to the ground floor is getting smaller and smaller with distance up to a point where it isn't resolvable anymore. At that point, this angle is still less than the one to the fifth floor, so the bottom floor disappears first. He doesn't realize that his line of reasoning means that the bottom floor disappears, although the entire building still stays in sight. And when you can see the entire building, you by definition also can see the entire ground floor. It's a classical example of the self-contradiction fallacy. But it is even worse. What he should have done was draw the angles from the observer to the higher floors individually. He would have seen that the angle becomes smaller the higher the floor is. The ground floor has an angular size of 9.46 degrees. The first floor has an angular size of 8.97 degrees. The second floor, 8.13 degrees. The third, 7.13 degrees, the fourth 6.12 degrees, and the fifth 5.19 degrees. So with increasing distance on a flat earth, the fifth floor would disappear first, then the fourth, then the third, then the second, then the first, and the ground floor will disappear last, not first. And this will be true for every floor that is higher than twice the eye height of the observer. In reality, however, we observe that the ground floor will disappear first, not last. Thank you, Gary Wiebenga. You have rather convincingly demonstrated that the world most certainly cannot be flat.